Hello friends, welcome back to the lecture 2 on water softening methods, right? So in today's class, I'll discuss the water softening method, and in this particular lecture, I will be discussing only lime soda process of water softening, and then I'll solve a few numericals based on lime soda process, which are very, very important for your end semester or say for your semester examination, right? So, if you recall in my last lecture, I'll explain the types of the water hardness and what is water hardness, how we can identify the hard and the soft water, right? And then I have introduced the units of the water hardness, right? So, in today's class, you can see here, I'm going to discuss these water softening methods. So, basically, if you see this slide here, so in industry, basically, lime soda process is mainly used for the softening of the water, hard water, and ion exchange method is also there, but it is used in those industries which are actually interested in the highly pure water, like you say water for medicinal purposes and all these things, right? Ion free water, if they demand, if they want, then they use this ion exchange process. And the third process is actually the geolite process. So these three are actually used in the industry regularly. However, there is another method which is reverse osmosis of water softening. It is also there, but it is not very frequently used in the industries, right? But I'll discuss that also. But in today's class, I'll discuss only this lime soda process. Okay. So what is lime and what is soda? You should know the chemical formula of these, right? So if you recall your basic chemistry, then you must know whenever I am talking about lime, so it is calcium hydroxide, okay? That means your calcium hydroxide, which is also known as what? Lime water, CaOH whole twice. So this is your lime, and this lime is responsible for the removal of the temporary hardness, okay? And if I am talking about the soda, definitely I am talking about my washing soda, which is sodium carbonate. And the formula of sodium carbonate, you all know, it is Na2CO3, okay? And this soda will remove actually the temporary, the permanent hardness from the water sample, okay? So whenever you react your water sample with lime and soda, there should be precipitation of some impurities in the form of the precipitate, right? So you can see here, calcium carbonate, it is the insoluble one, okay? So you can remove this, you can quantify this, you can identify this. Similarly, magnesium hydroxide is also a precipitate, right? So you can do the analysis for the water, so you can identify the amount of this present in the water, right? So how this lime soda process works actually? See, in industry, basically two types of the lime soda process are used. First process is actually which occurs at the room temperature, or rather we should say the temperature which is there in the environment actually, right? So this is known as the cold lime soda process. Don't confuse in the word cold. Cold doesn't mean that mean you are doing this in extremely low temperature. Cold lime soda process means the lime soda process which is happening or which is occurring at the prevailing atmospheric temperature, okay? And when I'm talking about the hot lime soda process, definitely I'm heating my water along with the reagents so that the reaction rate would be faster, okay? So it will occur at little bit higher temperature. Two types of the processes are used. So first I am discussing my cold lime soda process, okay? So what I will do in my lime soda, cold lime soda process, which I have actually summarized here, which I have written here. So see, before discussing this, going into the detail of this particular slide, what I can do, I can move to the diagram, a rough diagram for this lime soda process. Say this is this diagram, I have taken this cross-section diagram for this one, okay? And you can see here, very easily see this is the chamber actually, and in this chamber there are wood fibers, and these are filtering aid, nothing but they are the filtering aid, right? Water will percolate or will go through these wood fibers, and the impurities which can be actually filtered with these wood fibers will be separated here only, okay? And in this, here you can see an electrically driven belt is there. This is electrically driven belt, right? And this is the motor. Because it is electrically driven, definitely it's a motor. And it's actually, this is what? This system is there for actually to mix the water with the chemicals which we generally use. It is a kind of stirrer, you can see, okay? And this is the stand of this one. And finally, this opening you can observe here. This opening is actually for the removal of the sludge. And by definition, you know, sludge in any kind of the machine, sludge is the unwanted material, waste material, which we actually have to remove, which we have to discard from the system. So this sludge can have the different formula depending upon the hardness of the water. Here you can see, this top, this is the inlet. From this inlet, what I am doing, I am inserting my raw water, or say inserting my chemicals actually, not raw water. So I am delivering through this actually inlet soda, that is sodium carbonate, lime, that is calcium hydroxide. And if I am doing my reaction or my process, cold lime soda process, then it is necessary to add some coagulant, right? So why I'll add some coagulant in this? So you can think in that manner, you can recall your basic colloidal chemistry in that manner. So there may be a chance just like that. I can draw a diagram for this one, right? So right. So guys, you are listening actually this little noise here. Kindly adjust, because some fresher party is going on. That's why students are actually shouting here and there. Please adjust, okay? So what you can see here, okay? Okay guys, so what I can do, I can explain why we actually generally use the coagulant when we do the lime soda process at actually the room temperature or at the prevailing temperature. For example, say this is your water sample, okay? This is your water sample which you are actually softening, okay? And it happens that this water sample, after the proper treatment, it may have some suspended particles which are not settling down. So they are very fine particles, right? So what can happen, because their size is quite small, so they are very light weighted and they do not settle down. So for this, what we can do, we can add some coagulant to it, right? Coagulant, say you can add sodium aluminate, you can add your aluminium hydroxide. So that particular coagulant will trap these particles, and these particles then grow in the size, and once they grow in the size, they immediately settle down. And once they settle down, they can easily be removed from your apparatus, right? That's why in cold lime soda process, we generally use the coagulant. And you can see from here, we actually putting, or you see, this is the inlet for your raw water. Raw water means that is hard water. So this hard water is entering from the right hand side, and the chemicals are coming from the left hand side, and this actually stirrer is mixing the water and the chemicals to all together, and they are floating in that manner. See, it is coming here, and this wood fiber actually, these are the actually what, filter, these are the filtering aid, nothing else. And when this happens actually, and after that you will remove water from here, right? This is this arrow which you can see here. This is actually your soft water. So this is the process which is going automatically. If you remember my last slide, then I told you this magnesium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide, these are precipitated, right? So these two chemicals are responsible for the formation of the sludge in the water molecule chiefly, right? Because they are insoluble. And from here, these sludge can be removed. So this is just the cross-section diagram, okay? And whenever this question comes in your examination, so first thing you will do, you will draw this particular diagram to explain the thing. So there is no need to write a detailed theory of this. You simply draw the diagram, write the chemical reactions, and that's it, right? Now I'm going back to the previous slide, this particular one. This is the cold lime soda process, right? In this method, the calculated quantity of the chemical like lime and soda are mixed with water at room temperature. At room temperature, the precipitate forms are finely divided, as I have explained in my next slide. So they So they do not settle down easily and cannot be filtered. Consequently, it is essential to add small amounts of coagulant like alum, aluminium sulfate, right, sodium aluminate, etc., which hydrolyze to flocculent, gelatinous precipitate of aluminium hydroxide. And this aluminium hydroxide will entraps fine particles, and these particles then grow in size and they settle down immediately and can be removed as the sludge from there actually. Now, this I have explained in my next slide. But see, these chemicals are, you can add, but if you add the sodium aluminate as the coagulant, so it is having then added advantage. What is the added advantage? If your water is having the silica, this can be removed. Very easily this can be removed with the help of the sodium aluminate. Or if water is having oil, see, whenever your water sample is having oil, it may actually result in the foaming, which is a type of the boiler trouble, which we will discuss later. So removal of oil would also occur with this sodium aluminate if they are present in the water. And after the treatment, whatever the water you will get, so they will have the residual hardness of 50 to 60 ppm. So you can see parts per million is a very small unit. And if after the treatment, this much of hardness is there in the water sample, so there is no problem for the boilers to generate the steam. And these two chemical reaction, you can see this is the sodium aluminate, right, which I was discussing here. This is where, right, this is your sodium aluminate, okay. And this sodium aluminate, when reacts with the water, it produces aluminium hydroxide, right. And this aluminium hydroxide then traps the fine particles, okay. So you can see, or you can use aluminium sulfate also. So second one is what? Aluminium sulfate, right. So these are the two different reactions. So if you use sodium aluminate, then this reaction is fine. If you use aluminium sulfate, then again this aluminium hydroxide is there. Actually, this aluminium hydroxide traps the fine particles and they grow bigger in size and then they settle down easily. Okay, this is the thing which I have explained in the diagram also. Methods, so there is no need to read and write method again and again. Then there comes the hot lime soda process. See guys, when you do the hot lime soda process, the only advantage is that you won't add in that case your coagulant, because the reaction rate at the elevated temperature is very, very high. Okay, when the reaction rate is high, that means the fine particles would not be there. They collide with each other, they do reaction and they immediately settle down. So there is no need the coagulation, but you can see the added advantages here. The reaction rate is the faster, the softening capacity is increased by many fold, the precipitate and sludge form settle down rapidly, no coagulants are required. Since you are heating the water, if carbon dioxide is there, it would be removed, right, driven out from the water sample. And as you know, when you increase the temperature, the viscosity goes down. So if your water is too viscous, that means when water is too viscous, that this actually hot lime soda process will also decrease the viscosity of your water sample, right. And you can see the residual hardness is still 15 to 30 ppm, but it is comparatively lower than the cold lime soda process method, okay. And you can see this is the picture of your hot lime soda process. So what we have done here, actually this diagram is just the diagram, but this is the diagram which I have shown you a few slides back actually. And you can see precipitate is here and this is your water is moving, this is your hard water, right, chemicals are coming from here. But in this case, what I am doing, or what actually the industry will do, they actually provide a next facility here, which is the filtering aid. If it is the soft water coming from here, and if you filter that particular water, then definitely the filtered water would be more soft than the previous one. So this is the added advantage. So in that case, what we are doing, superheated steam inlet is there. So superheated steam we will pass from here, and raw water, that means hard water, would come from here to here. Chemicals are coming from here to here. Okay. So this is the reaction tank where the reaction is happening. And all the reactions would happen, and then your precipitate would settle down from here in the form of the calcium and the magnesium hydroxide. If this process is combined with the filtering aid, right, Then this filtering aid, you can see here what is there. See, this is actually very fine sand particle layer, and this layer is the coarse sand. Little see, this particle of the sand would be a little more when compared to the fine in the coarse sand. And finally, I'll have some wood fiber and sand filters. And the, so what we are doing, we are actually doing the extra filtration here, nothing else. Okay. And whatever I have explained in this particular diagram, actually I have summarized here also. Okay. You can see here, hot lime soda plant consists essentially three parts: reaction tank, which I have explained, a conical sedimentation vessel, which is this one. This is your sedimentation tank. Okay, conical sedimentation tank. Fine. And then sand filter, which ensures the complete removal of the sludge. Okay, so this is how your hot lime soda process goes. And advantages, see, there must be, why industry is using this hot lime soda process very conveniently, because you can see this process is very economical, because in this process, whatever chemical you are using, they are very cheap. Soda is very cheap, lime is very cheap, okay. And if the process is combined with the sedimentation with coagulation, then the lesser amounts of the coagulant shall be needed, or no amount of the coagulant would be needed. Okay. The process increases the pH value of the treated water. Since you are using the sodium hydroxide, it will dissolve in the water to produce the sodium hydroxide. You have using, sorry, sodium carbonate actually you are using. And when this sodium carbonate reacts with the water, it will produce the sodium hydroxide. And you know the sodium hydroxide is the alkali, which increases the pH of the water sample. Whenever the pH increases, so the corrosion of the distribution pipe is reduced. As you know, the corrosion occurs generally in the acidic environment. But here you are giving the alkaline environment, so the corrosion rate would decrease. Okay. Besides the removal of the hardness, it is not actually hardness, D should be there. Besides the removal of the hardness, the quantity of the other minerals in water is also reduced. If iron and manganese are present in some amount, then they can also be removed. Due to the alkaline nature of the treated water, some pathogenic bacteria in the water is considerably reduced. Since the nature is the alkaline, and you know that in the alkaline nature, microbes actually generally die. So this is the advantage. These are the advantages. Then there comes the some disadvantages also. So what disadvantages we can have with this lime soda process? For efficient and the economical softening, careful supervision and skilled supervision is required. And you know, whenever the careful and skilled supervision is required, that means industry have to appoint a person or engineer for this process, and it will cost, right? So economically, you can see there is a little disadvantage which industry can have actually, okay? And finally, disposal of the large amount of the sludge. See, calcium carbonate, magnesium hydroxide, which precipitates out as the sludge, their disposal actually is quite difficult, right, in the industry. And see, residual hardness 50 to 30 ppm is still there. So it's not very good for your boilers, but somehow we can use this water in the boiler also. Now there comes the chemistry of this one. So before going into the chemistry, you can see this particular formula, right? Lime requirement for softening in milligram per liter. So this is the formula. See, I have given straight away the formula. I haven't derived this particular formula because there is no need to derive this formula. You can simply use this formula to calculate the lime and soda requirement. And formula is what you can do. You can take the snapshot of this one. The little thing I want to explain here, what I have written here, see, lime requirement equals to 74/100. 74 is the molecular weight of calcium hydroxide, that is this lime, okay. 100 is there for your calcium carbonate, or say, sorry, yes, for calcium carbonate, okay. Then your calcium bicarbonate is already here. See, if temporary hardness in the form is there, so you can write the value of this temporary hardness given. But before putting that value here, you have to convert that calcium bicarbonate into its calcium carbonate equivalent by using the multiplication factor value, which I have explained in my last lecture actually. And then there comes the plus 2 into magnesium hardness, magnesium bicarbonate hardness. So one can ask this question from, see, in the, here you can see in case of the magnesium bicarbonate, we are multiplying the factor with the 2. But in case of the calcium bicarbonate, we are not multiplying this by 2. So answer comes from the reactions which I will explain, right? And then plus all kinds of hardness are there. So you can see here magnesium permanent hardness. Iron can also provide hardness because iron sulfate is soluble in the water sample. Similarly, aluminium can also provide. And important feature you can see here, carbon dioxide is there. So one can argue the carbon dioxide is a gas, how it can provide the hardness. So answer is quite simple. This carbon dioxide can react with the water to produce the carbonic acid, right? Which I have explained in my last class. And that carbonic acid then combined with the calcium or the magnesium salts or calcium ions to produce the calcium bicarbonate or the magnesium bicarbonate. So this carbon dioxide can cause hardness. That's why they have included this CO2 here. Then HCl can also cause hardness. H2SO4 can also cause hardness. Why they cause hardness or how they impart towards the hardness? If you ionize this HCl, then you will have the chloride ion. And if you ionize this sulfuric acid, then you will have your sulfate ion, right? So these sulfates and the chlorides would react with the calcium and the magnesium to produce the magnesium chloride and the magnesium sulfate. And calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate and all other sulfates, they are actually responsible for the hardness. So we have included them also here. Similarly, bicarbonate is also there. It can combine with the calcium or the magnesium. But you can see minus sodium aluminate I have written here. So why I have written this minus sodium aluminate? The answer actually lies here in the last slide. So guys, you can see here, this is my calcium bicarbonate and this causes the temporary hardness. And whenever I am removing the temporary hardness, that means I will react my substances with the lime as I have explained. So lime is calcium hydroxide. It is reacting with the calcium bicarbonate and precipitating down this calcium carbonate. And you can remove this calcium carbonate from here. So here you can see the need is what? Need is what? L. L means only one mole of lime is required, you can say, or one equivalent of lime is required. But if you have, say, calcium bicarbonate in the sample, right? So whenever you have this calcium bicarbonate in the sample, it will react with the 2 moles of calcium hydroxide, that means 2 moles of the lime. And then it precipitates actually what? The precipitate of this calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide. So one equivalent of magnesium bicarbonate is generally requiring 2 actually lime. That's why in the formula, this value is actually multiplied with the 2. As you can see here. Here you can see this 2 into magnesium bicarbonate. Okay, now it is very clear why actually this 2 is here. So 2L is written here. Similarly, if you see all the reactions, if magnesium permanent hardness is there, like magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate, these things are there, then they can see magnesium ion can react with the calcium hydroxide to precipitate magnesium hydroxide. So one lime is required. So you can write L here. And one calcium if there, then calcium will not react with calcium hydroxide because both cations are same. They cannot react, but these calcium ions can react with the sodium bicarbonate to precipitate calcium carbonate. So when your sample is having one magnesium ion, it is removing one calcium ion, and this calcium ion is actually need sodium carbonate. So here what I require for one magnesium ion, lime as well as soda. If you combine these two reactions right here, just like that, now I have written in the form of the salts calcium magnesium chloride in place of your magnesium ion and calcium chloride in case of the calcium ion, and then I'll require L plus S, that means lime plus soda. This is how you can react the reaction. And if you react, if you replace the chloride with the sulfates, then again the same thing would happen and you will require this particular one. And this bicarbonate, how it is causing hardness is this I have explained. It can react with the lime to produce the calcium carbonate, right? And again it is producing what? Soda. So soda you are not taking, but it is producing by the reaction. So this bicarbonate actually requires one lime, that is L, and producing one soda, that is L minus S. Similarly, for calcium ions, you can see here, these calcium ions are there. Calcium can react with the sodium carbonate and precipitates calcium bicarbonate. Similarly, chloride and sulfate of the calcium can react with the bicarbonate to produce these. Okay. So one soda here and one soda here they require, so S and S. Similarly, you can see here this carbon dioxide, this can react with the calcium hydroxide, and it will form actually calcium carbonate. So this is also producing, this is also required, this CO2 is also required one lime. So I have written L here. If free acidity is there, which comes from the HClH2SO4, so these H ions can react with the lime to produce the calcium ions, and these calcium ions can react with the soda to precipitate calcium carbonate. So what I required? I required one lime and one soda, so L plus S. If you do the more specifically, then lime, soda, soda for individual acids, these reactions are written here. Okay, and one note is also there. Aluminium and iron salts may be present in the water and contribute to the permanent hardness, right? If they are present, say if iron is there, so it will react with the lime to produce ferric hydroxide and calcium sulfate. So one lime is required, and this, ferrous hydroxide, and this ferrous hydroxide then react with the water and with the dissolved oxygen of the water, it will produce the ferric hydroxide, okay? And then calcium sulfate, which you have precipitated, it will react with the sodium carbonate to produce the calcium carbonate. So basically what I require? I require one lime, which I've written here, and one soda, that is L plus S. Similarly, the same thing you can explain for the aluminium also, right? L plus S. But if you have the sodium aluminate, then it can react with the water to produce the aluminium hydroxide and lime, okay? So that's why this sodium hydroxide, okay? Then this sodium hydroxide is there. It can react with the lime to produce what? Calcium hydroxide. That's why minus 1 L is written here. That means extra lime we are producing from here. So that's why these factors of 2 and these thing are there in the formula, final formula. So now you can see this particular formula. So this is the lime requirement, and remember it's in milligram per liter, and all these impurities must be reported in terms of the calcium carbonate equivalent, which I have explained, which would be the first method of your first actually step in your numericals. Similarly, if you required the soda, for soda requirement in milligram per liter, your formula is just like that. 106 by 100, you know, 106 is the molecular weight of the sodium carbonate, that is soda, divided by 100. And now we are calculating the permanent hardness. So calcium ions, right, and magnesium ions, since we are permanent hardness, so definitely the permanently hard water would be there. That means, and you know, the for permanent hardness, chloride and sulfates of the metal ions are responsible. So calcium chloride or calcium sulfate, magnesium chloride or magnesium sulfate, aluminium sulfate, iron sulfate, sulfuric acid, right, and minus actually bicarbonate, right? So these two formula are very, very important. And we can do the some modifications according to the required, according to the numerical which we generally solve. So I will solve two or three numericals based on this particular one. So this is all about your lime soda process. And remember one thing, if you are doing any numerical and you have given data, for calcium carbonate, and you have given data for magnesium carbonate, while other data are not given. So what you can do, you can put zero, you know, on their respective value. However, I will explain these points in my lecture also. So guys, this is the lime soda process theory, which is very, very important for your examination point of view. Now I'll solve a few numerical based on this, right? And then you will be able to solve the problem which may be there in your semester examination. Okay.
So guys, this is your first numerical, and the numerical is given here. Actually, it is the solved problem which I have taken from that Shashi Chawla, Engineering Chemistry by Shashi Chawla textbook, right? So you can see the question is just like that. Analysis of water giving the following results, in which these four impurities are there, which I have written here: sulfuric acid, magnesium sulfate, calcium sulfate, and sodium chloride. Okay, and whatever the water is there, this water sample has to be supplied to the 1 lakh persons actually, right? And daily consumptions of water is 50 liter per head or per person, you can say. And you have to calculate the cost of the lime and soda required for softening of this particular hard water, and say I can make one change in it. Say not change, actually it is given already for the month of the April, when the cost of the lime and soda is just like that. So this is the formula which you have just seen in few slides back, where I have shown you this formula of lime requirement and the soda requirement. So as you know, whenever you solve any numerical based on the water treatment, so first of all you have to convert all the hardness causing substances into their calcium carbonate equivalent. So I am doing the first step in that manner. So how I can write CaCO3 equivalent, CaCO3 equivalents of, say I am calculating for H2SO4, right? So for H2SO4 this would be 196 ppm is given already, and you know the multiplication factor for sulfuric acid or free acidity is what? 100 by 98. 100 is the molecular weight of calcium carbonate, 98 is the molecular weight of your say sulfuric acid, or you can use 50 by 49 also. If you don't want to use the molecular weight, you can use the atomic weight also. And if you solve this value, then it will give you somewhere around 200, right? So this value is actually your 200 ppm or 200 milligram per liter. So I can also write the unit milligram per liter, because this is given in the ppm, and I have written here is in milligram per liter. Ppm and milligram per liter both are same, and these are the ratios, so they don't have any unit, so the final calculation would be just like that. Similarly, I can calculate calcium carbonate equivalent of say magnesium sulfate, okay? And for magnesium sulfate, what is given? 24 is given. So you can take this 24 milligram per liter or ppm, and you can multiply it with its multiplication factor. And the multiplication factor of magnesium sulfate, as you know, it is 100 by 120. If you solve this value, then it will give you 20 milligram per liter or 20 ppm, right? Then third reagent is given what? Calcium sulfate. So calcium calcium carbonate equivalents of calcium sulfate, that is CaSO4, and the value would be 272, and multiplied by its multiplication factor. And you know the multiplication factor for calcium sulfate is 100 by 136. Okay, so 136 is the molecular weight of the calcium sulfate, and 100 is for your calcium carbonate. And if you solve this value, again this will give you 200 ppm, okay, or 200 milligram per liter or ppm, both are same. Now you can see here third impurity is also there in the form of the sodium chloride, but as I told you, sodium is the soft metal, it doesn't contribute towards the hardness, so there is no need to include that particular sodium chloride concentration in your numerical. So this is how we are getting these things. Now we can require, now we can calculate the lime requirement. So how I can calculate the lime requirement, you can see. So I am doing for lime. So that would be equal to lime requirement. Okay, so according to the formula, 74 by 100, I would write just like that. Okay, now let's start my bracket. Temporary calcium hardness, so no temporary calcium hardness is there, right? But because see, you know the calcium temporary hardness is due to the bicarbonates and the carbonates of the metal ions, but in that case you haven't any carbonates and the bicarbonates, so you can put zero instead of putting anything, right? So I can either you can skip this part or you can put zero here. Then you are having say temporary magnesium hardness, right? So then you will have your temporary magnesium hardness. Again, magnesium carbonate and bicarbonate are not there, so you can remove this one. Now going to the permanent hardness, of course magnesium sulfate is there, and you know magnesium sulfate and the hardness corresponding to this magnesium sulfate is what? It is actually say 200, right? Sorry, 20. It is 20. And of course you can see the free acidity, that means H positive is also there. And for sulfuric acid, the value is what? It is coming out to be actually 200. So what you can do, you can write 200 here. Okay, so both these units, and nothing other ions are there in given in the question, so you can stop here. And you know this value is actually in the milligram per liter, so you can write in that manner. Okay, and this water has to be supplied for the people of this 1 lakh persons actually. So you can write 1 lakh here. That is, say I am writing 10 raised the power 5 persons. Okay, and then you can see the per head capacity is what for daily consumption. That means 50 liters per person. 50 liter per person. So what you can do, liter would cancel liters, persons would cancel persons, and whatever you will calculate, the value would come into the milligrams actually. So if you solve this value, so this will give you say 220 multiplied by 74 by 100. So you can use your calculator, as this calculator is allowed in the beta examination. So 162.8, okay, into 50 and into this 10 raised to the power 5, and this will give you 814123 and another 23 milligrams. This much of a milligram lime would be required, and you know 10 raised to the power 6 milligram would correspond to the 1 kilogram. So you can convert this value into the milligram kilogram. So how would you convert this into the kilogram? So you would divide this value 814000 and 000 here divided by 10 is the power 6, because they are, it is given in the milligram and you are converting it into the kilogram. Okay, so that's why you will divide this value with that 10 is the power 6, and if you solve that value, then it will come 814 kilogram. Okay, so this is 814 kilogram, and this is actually for one day, and you have to supply this water for the month of the April, and you know that in the month of the April there are 30 days. So for April month, that would be 814 into 30. That is, if you multiply these two, 24420 kilogram. So this much kilogram is required actually. And you know the cost is what? Cost is given 5 rupees per kg. 5 rupees per kg. So you can calculate this one. 24420. Right? This much of kg actually required. And the cost is what? 5 rupees per kg. So kg, kg. They would cancel each other, okay, and when they cancel each other, and if you solve this factor, then it will give you 122100 rupees, right? So it is something like that. 1,22,100 rupees would be the cost of the lime for the water softening. Okay, now we can calculate for the soda requirement. So for soda requirement, the formula is what? 106 by 100. So you will write 106 by 100. And then again, you will do the same thing. You have calculated. See, permanent calcium hardness, of course, calcium sulfate is there in the 200 milligram per liter. So you can write 200 plus. Then magnesium ions, permanent magnesium ions, of course, magnesium sulfate is there. So you will write 20 here. You know, chloride and the sulfates of the metal ions causes permanent hardness, right? And then aluminium is not there, iron is not there, but acidity is there actually, and it is present in the 200 milligram per liter of amount. So you have converted this value into this one also, right? Sorry, not 196, this H2SO4 is present, and you have converted this into calcium carbonate equivalent. So you can write 200 here, and all the factors would remain same. 550 liters per day, there is no problem, and the population is 10 is the power 5. And if you see, like I have solved the units here, so now I am assuming that you are aware how to actually cancel the units and get the final unit. So this is in milligram per liter, okay, and if you solve this value, okay, fine, if you solve this value, then it would be say somewhere around 445.2. So 2 to the 4, 420 multiplied by 106 by 100, that will give you 445 this much, and 50 liters per head, and then the 10 is the power 5. And if you solve this value, then you will find 22260 and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this much of milligram. Okay, now if you convert this into the milligram, so I am doing here only. So what you can do, you can divide it by 10 is the power 6 as I already did here actually. And if you solve this value, so 32 60 60, these zeros would gone, this gone, and finally you will have 2226 kg. This is for one day. And if you calculate for April, so 2226 multiply by 30. Okay, and of course the cost of lime, cost of soda is what, 8 rupees. So I am doing here only 8, and this will give you 534240 rupees. So this is the answer. This is how you can calculate the lime and soda requirement when you do the numerical based on this. So this is the first numerical. See, this numerical can be actually numerical can have the many variations. Like somewhere you have, you can also say like in that manner. I have to solve one more numerical, okay, to make the things a little more clearer. So again, you can see the data is given here. HCl, MgCl2, aluminium sulfate, and this. So now you are, I am calculating for the lime requirement. So guys, this I will do little fast. So what you have to do, you have to keep in mind this particular formula. Okay, when you have this formula in your mind, then there is no problem. So here you can see I have calculated the calcium carbonate equivalents, all these things, but in the second numerical I will not do in that manner. Straight away I will put the values here. Just like that, 7.3 is given here. So I will write 7.3 and multiply that 7.3 into its multiplication factor, and similarly I will do for all these impurities, so that the numerical would not take very much time. Okay, so I'm solving this particular one, and I am going for say lime requirement. Okay, and lime requirement, of course, it is in milligram per liter, you should aware. This is 74/100 lime factor. Okay, and then I am having my HCl free acidity, so I can write 7.3, and the multiplication factor for HCl is 100/73. Okay, so 36.5 is actually the molecular weight of HCl. And you know, when you're, see, this is very important to understand, when you have this HCl and if you ionize this, then it will produce 1H positive and 1Cl negative. And if you have say calcium ions, say Ca2 positive, so these Ca2 positive will require 2Cl negative to form CaCl2. Okay, similarly it is true for the magnesium chloride also, it will require the 2 of your chloride. And I am not actually doing for your tri-positive ions, because generally in water sample we have the 2 positive, magnesium or the calcium ion. So that's why 36.5 is the molecular weight of this one. So multiplication factor, I will multiply that 36.5 by 2, right? Because two equivalents of the chloride ions are required to precipitate one of your calcium ion. This I have already explained in my video also, okay, earlier, see, in the earlier part of this particular lecture. And then I'll move further. Then I am having the next impurity, and my next impurity is say 34.2. it is given here, say magnesium chloride 9.5 is given here. So you can write say 9.5 milligram per liter, and the multiplication factor of this is what, 100/95. So this is the multiplication factor for this one. And then I'll do for this aluminium sulfate, which is 34.2, the value is given here, and the multiplication factor for this is 100/114, right? This I have shown you in the earlier part of this particular lecture, and all these values would be in the milligram per liter. There is no problem in that. And if you see the volume of the water which has to be softened by this method actually is what, your 1 lakh liters. So what you can do, you can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 liters, 1 lakh liters you can write in that manner. Okay, and whatever the value would come, actually it will come into the milligram per liter. Okay, so how I can do that? I'll convert it this into the milligram per liter. So I can straight away writing say 1, okay, kg here I am writing, and I am dividing this value by 10 raised to the power 6. So I am doing straightforward in that manner. Okay, so this is in milligram per liter. Why I am doing this? Because I have explained this particular phenomenon here. Whatever the value would you would get, you will get this value in the milligram, and then you will convert this into the milligram, and you will convert this into the kilogram, and for this conversion you have to multiply the factor by the 10 raised to the power 6. So that's why in the manner, the manner in which the question is given in the book, I am writing in that manner. So what I am doing, whatever the value would come, I would divide that value with the 10 raised to the power 6, right? If you solve all these parameters, then you will find it would come 3.7 kg. Okay, so this much of lime is required for softening the 1 lakh liters of the water, which is having the following impurities. And you can notice one very important point here. Again, I am not including that sodium chloride here, because it will not cause any kind of the hardness. But if you see, your lime actually is not 100% pure, it is only 90% pure. So if you see, if you know the how to actually use the unitary method for these percentage problems, which you have done your class 6th and the class 7th, then there is no problem. And it is expected from the engineering BTech student that they must know actually how to apply this method of this unitary method. Okay, so this much is given. Now applying unitary method, so this is given 3.57, okay, 3.7, okay, and percentage purity is 90%. So you will multiply that factor by 100 by 90. However, one can argue very easily why you are actually doing this one, because 90% purity means 90 by 100. Okay, so you can very easily correlate actually, right? So how you can correlate this with this value? It's very easy. Please wait, just in that manner you can do. See, 90 by 100 actually correspond to the 3.7 kilogram which you have calculated. If you do for 1 by unitary method, then it would be 100 by 90. Okay, so that's why I'm multiplying that factor by 100 by 90. And you know, 10% of the chemicals are used in the excess. So whatever the amount of the chemicals are required, you are using the extra 10%. That means 100% is already there and you are using extra 10%. So 110% actually you are using, 110%. So 110% means 110 by 100. So whatever the factor would come, you will multiply that factor by actually again 110 by 100. So now you will not invert that value because you are using in the excess. Again, you can apply the unitary method. Okay, I am not doing that one. So if you solve this particular value, it will give you 4.52 kg. Okay, this much of actually lime is required for softening 1 lakh liters of the water which have the following impurities. Okay, and cost, there is no question of cost because cost is not given here. Similarly, you can go for the soda requirement. Okay, soda requirement. So how you will go for the soda requirement? You know, for soda the formula is 106 by 100. As you know, this you can see here, this is 106 by 100. Okay, and then the impurity is present in, right, acid is there. Okay, acid is there, that means 7.3, and you know the multiplication factor is what? 100 by 73. Plus then you can see again the factor, this 9.5 is already here. So again this is 100 by 95, plus another impurity is aluminium sulphate. So 34.2 actually 100 by 114. So all things remain same like we did earlier. So it is in milligram per liter, and you know the waters of liters are 1, 2, 3, 5, 1 lakh liters of water. So you can write liters here, and whatever the value would come, it would be in the milligram per liter. So you will convert this into 1 kg by 10 is the power 6 milligram. Okay, so liter would liter cancel, milligram and milligram cancel, like I did here. So whatever the answer would come, it is 5.3 kg somewhere. Okay, the value is just like that. And again, you can do that multiplication factor. Okay, unitary method, percentage purity. So for the percentage purity, 5.3 is already there, and it is 98% pure. So like you did here actually, where you have multiplied by 100 by 90. So here you will do 100 by 98. So you can remember that value, that thing, in that manner also. Again, this factor would remain same because you are using 10% in the excess actually. Okay, if you solve this factor, it will give you 5.95 kg. Okay, so this is how you can see the numerical can be solved based on the lime soda process. So I hope this lime soda process, the principle, the chemical reactions, derivation, how to learn the formula, how to convert all the hardness causing substances into their calcium carbonate equivalents, and then how to calculate the cost of lime and soda required, amount of lime and soda required, and percentage factors, all these things, right? So I think this is sufficient to understand the lime soda process, and this would be very, very beneficial for your examination point of view, because generally these questions are there in your semester examination. So this is the end of the lecture. Kindly subscribe the tetrahedron chemistry classes, share with your friends, especially this particular lecture you can share with your BTech first year students, which are actually studying in the different colleges. Okay, thank you very much.